Greetings and welcome to Research 101. In this series, we will be discussing the concepts and skills involved in doing research. In this episode, we're going to talk about what research is and explain the first step in doing any research, which is finding a research topic. Research is essentially the process of asking questions and looking for answers. You may not realize it, but you do this all the time. For example, suppose that it's almost dinner time and you're in the mood for something different, so you decide to go out and try some Brazilian food. Okay, first you need to find a place that sells Brazilian food. So off you go to Google Maps and look to see if there are any Brazilian restaurants nearby. And you're in luck, there are a few. So now you want to make sure that you can afford dinner and you aren't wasting your money on lousy food. So maybe you check the Google reviews or look the place up on Yelp and check out the menu and some photos. You find out that the first place is a steakhouse that charges $40 a plate, so probably not. There are a bunch of reviews on the second place that people got sick after eating there, so also probably not. The last place, however, looks good, so you grab your keys and go have dinner. Congratulations! You just did research. Don't believe me? Well, let's review. You had a question, right? You wanted to know where you could get Brazilian food you could afford that would be worth your money. Okay, great. You gathered evidence from sources you trusted that provided you with multiple places to eat, and then gathered more evidence that helped you decide which place to go to. And then, armed with your answer, you went and had dinner. You had a question, you gathered evidence, you answered your question. In a nutshell, you did research. Now, of course, this is a really basic example in comparison to the kind of research you're going to be doing in your academic and professional life, but it demonstrates the basic principle. Research involves developing a question, gathering evidence to answer that question, and drawing conclusions from that evidence. Your professors do the same kind of thing every day. No, really. And not just deciding what to have for dinner. In every discipline, research starts with a question. We may be trying to find an answer as to why something happened, or testing a hypothesis, or measuring a reaction of some sort, but we're all trying to answer questions of some sort. To answer these questions, we gather evidence. Evidence can take a whole lot of different forms. It can be archival texts, survey responses, research data, field measurements, etc. There are, however, a couple of things all of this evidence should have in common. One, it should all be based in observable, measurable, or documented facts. Two, if it involves experimental results, it should be replicable, meaning that someone else who did the experiment using the same methodology should get the same results. Having gathered this evidence, we analyze it and try and draw conclusions from it. So, from the cost of dinner at the first restaurant, we drew the conclusion that we couldn't afford to eat there. And from the reviews of the second restaurant, we drew the conclusion we might get sick if we ate there. Researchers do much the same thing. They look at the evidence and draw conclusions about whether treatments are effective, if designs will work, about the reasons historical figures did things, etc. Maybe after having dinner, you wondered what a different meal on the menu is like. In this case, your answer has raised new questions, requiring further research. At another meal, obviously. Well, researchers often run into similar questions raised by the answers they've found. So research, much like the search for a great place to eat, is never totally done. So assuming you get the choice, how do you pick a research topic? Well, your best bet is to pick a topic that interests you. You could think of a research topic as the worst roommate you've ever had. It's going to follow you everywhere you go, every waking and maybe even dreaming hour of your day, until you get your project done. So since it's going to be on your mind anyway, it may as well be something interesting to you. Furthermore, if it bores you to talk about your topic, it's probably going to be boring to research. So pick something that interests you, a question you want to learn the answer to, a concept you want to experiment with, and so forth. Having picked an area of interest, you're now going to have to come up with a question to ask, or a hypothesis to test in that area. There are three basic characteristics of a good research question: specificity, complexity, and answerability. First, your question needs to be specific enough. Realize that you're only going to have between 5 and 20 pages on average for an undergraduate research project. So you're going to want a question that you can discuss in depth in the space provided. With that in mind, consider the following proposed question. What caused the First World War? Is this a good research question? Probably not. The causes of the First World War are complex and convoluted, and thousands of pages and hundreds of books have been written on the topic, so it's going to need more space to cover and more time to research than you're going to have in a single semester course. So let's go more specific. How about, what role did Serbian nationalism play in starting the First World War? This is better. Instead of trying to cover all the causes of the war, this question focuses on a single aspect of the broader question and tries to explore how important it was. So when coming up with a research question, always ask yourself, am I being specific enough? Second, your question needs to be complex enough to require serious research. There are a lot of really specific questions out there that can be answered pretty easily. For example, consider this question. How many people live in the United States? Is this a good research question? Also, no. Yes, it's specific, too specific. A simple trip to Google or Wikipedia or the U.S. Census Bureau's website will answer that for you in a matter of seconds, which is great, but it's going to be hard to take that answer and write about it for 5 to 20 pages. So instead, let's consider what regions of the United States are experiencing population growth and what are the factors contributing to it. This is still a pretty specific question, but this isn't something you're going to be able to answer in a single sentence. In this case, you're going to have to look at data to figure out what areas are currently growing and find out if they have anything in common, and if so, how those factors might or might not lead to population growth. So not only does your question have to be specific enough to answer in the time and space provided, it also has to be complex enough to require more than a quick trip to Wikipedia. Finally, a good research question usually needs to be answerable. What does this mean? It means that through the collection of data, those observable, measurable facts we talked about earlier, be it experimental, documentary, statistical, or observational data, you should be able to come to some conclusion regarding your question. Now, I will admit there are exceptions to this rule. Some disciplines, like philosophy, will try to use logic and argument to discuss questions that might otherwise be considered unanswerable, and there's a whole different skill set involved in writing those kind of papers. But generally speaking, when you work on a research project, you're trying to collect data to come to some form of conclusion, even if that conclusion is, we don't have enough data to really know. And that requires you to ask a question that you can collect data on. So, for example, is this a good research question? Does evil exist? Well, I'm not going to say that you're not going to find evidence of evil in the world. But in order to do this, you have to define evil. And that definition has to be something that everyone agrees with. Good luck with that. And you're going to have to defend how that example you found fits the definition, etc., etc. So it's a little complicated. How about this question? How do millennials define evil? Okay, here's a specific question that's likely to be somewhat complicated, but in this case, you can collect data. You can do a survey on a sample of millennial-age individuals, asking them carefully constructed questions about the nature of evil, and then come to some sort of conclusion on this topic. So ultimately, when you ask a research question, it should be 1. Specific enough to answer within the space and time provided, 2. Complex enough to require research beyond a brief answer from Google or Wikipedia, and 3. Something you can collect data on and come to a conclusion. Now let's say you have a topic that fascinates you, but you don't know enough about it to ask a question that is sufficiently specific, complex, and answerable enough to start a research project. This is where background research comes in. The library has a wide variety of reference sources, including dictionaries, subject-specific encyclopedias, which go in depth on a single subject, like psychology, for example, and reference databases, all of which will provide you with brief descriptions of topics, helping you get the basic facts and a brief overview to get you started. From these sources, you may be able to narrow down your topic from a broad field of interests to a specific research question. You can also come to the library and talk to your subject librarian. We're pretty good at helping you narrow down your topic, and we can help point you in the direction of resources that can provide you with the background information you need to get started on your research journey.